man with a fire in his belly, a man of substance and substantive thought. He's the real deal. He's anti-status quo, anti-insider, and he's the only candidate who could replace Bill Nelson, who has served in the military, United States Army. He preached a consistent and conservative message, including job creation, lower taxes, smaller government, secure borders, strong military, and a passionate belief in American exceptionalism. I think that's the most important right there. He got 8 standing ovations with his inspirational speech at the Republican Leadership Conference in New Orleans last month. I happened to watch it on TV. It was great. He did a great job. His campaign to represent the GOP in unseating Nelson has been described as a summer groundswell rolling across the state of Florida, a surging grassroots phenomenon. In last year's gubernatorial race against Rick Scott and Bill McCollum, he garnered over 10% of the Republican primary vote after campaigning for only 55 days. Quite an accomplishment there. Today, with most of our elected voters still undecided, he's bringing his message to us. It's a very real pleasure. I'm proud to introduce Colonel Mike McCalister. Big hands for Mike.
Get beat on to do that daily, but I just don't think that solves our problems. I don't think it proves the credentials of the people throwing the food. I would also say that certain things we all know, we're Republicans. You know, we know we got to cut spending. We know we need less taxes, less regulation. And I'll mention those tonight, but folks, it's going to take a lot more than that to save this country. And I would say this, don't be fooled by polls and media coverage that you see out there. What a game. I mean, I got to tell you, out here running, I have days I get really frustrated. It's manipulated. You know, we did see a Facebook poll the other day, which was kind of nice because it didn't come out of the campaign. We were running second. Number 3 guy dropped out. Number 4 guy, number 5 guy are there. I got to give credit to George. He won. As I've been around him, as he mentioned my background, I'll tell you quickly. Yes, I have a doctorate in business management. My undergrad degree is in agriculture. I am a tree farmer. I have an industry license. I'm a practicing professional. I'm a graduate of the Command and General Staff College, which was a great school. I'm a graduate of the War College, which was the best school I ever did. You have to be a lieutenant colonel with a top secret clearance to get in. Somehow I made it. It's where you study how this country actually operates globally. I'm the executive office of the president. Not on this political ground, but we're seeing it here, and you're going to hear a lot more for the next year. I would say to you that, you know, as we go forward, there's certain issues we've got to resolve, and you all are going to make a hiring decision next year. You got one statewide office, and I'm just going to ask you to treat it just like you would in the workplace. Here's the job description. It's not a one-size-fits-all. U.S. Senate's a very unique body. We'll talk about that. My core values, I'm Christian. God fearing first, women fearing second. I believe in family. I was a single parent, raised a son from the time he was 4 by myself. We're both Eagle Scouts and God and country. Pride and joy in my life. Trials and tribulations of that. We all know how it works, right? I was humming along thinking I had it made. You know, patting myself on the back. He's in 10th grade, gets a plaque. Had a 4.0 in the gifted program on the football team, starts 11th grade. They get mobile, we've dumbed everything down to the point they get bored, and they think they know everything at 17, he gets kicked out of school. Wow. Clipped hamburgers at Wendy's for a year. Never went back. I was pulling my hair out. Going wild, I was going nuts, you know, but that was the greatest job he ever had. He identified that may not be his ideal future. And 5 years ago, he was the only student that graduated from the University of Florida getting a Master of Engineering and a law degree at the same time. Yeah. You know, there's a lesson there for us with our education. education system, I tell you. I think we've got to have personal responsibility, reward hard work and doing what's right. I'm pro-life, quite conservative, and proud to be an American. I want to recognize some, I was going to recognize the seniors, but as I look around, I don't see any. It's my one schmooze, okay? I'll be 60 this year, and I read the other day we're now up to 75 for claiming to be middle-aged. I want to recognize anyone in here that's a single parent or grew up in a single-parent household. Believe it or not, 50% of our youth today in America is growing up in single-parent households. And 80% of the time, that household's managed by a woman. And it's just another reason why we have to make sure the ladies have equal opportunity and equal pay in the workplace. They're raising our kids and our grandkids. You know, you hear it said, but it is true, this is still the greatest nation on the planet. America is the world's last true global military power and protector of freedom and democracy around the world. As a fairly recently retired colonel, I can proudly tell you that we do have the finest young airmen, seamen, soldiers, and Marines of any country on the planet. And we have to make sure Washington continues to give them everything they need to fight and win in battle.
Yes.
Now, as we go through tonight, I'll make you this commitment. I won't stand up here and talk about things that I don't either have an accredited degree, a professional license, or serious real-world experience in. I'm listening to the other guys talk. You'll get plenty of the other of that. But ask yourself when they're talking. If they're talking about national security, ask yourself, what's your real experience with national defense and the global economy? Because it's what you're going to hire someone to do. You know, Americans never need to go anywhere on this planet and hang their head. This country, with its most precious blood, has saved the world more than once. And I think that we're all tired of a president standing on foreign soil, bowing to Muslim kings, apologizing to the world for who and what we are. Yeah. And it's got to stop. Yeah. I was talking with some of you earlier tonight, and we have a lot of vets in here. So like many of you, I came from a military family. Ended up being an Army guy. Army National Guard, a couple years in the Florida Guard, in fact. Army Reserves, active duty Army. I was active duty colonel, U.S. Special Operations Command. I was an active duty private E-1 back in 1972 at Fort Jackson. I would like to recognize all the veterans in here. Would you stand up for us? Our nation's heroes. You know, you hear people say nobody likes America anymore. Now, when I'm not running for U.S. Senate, I teach grad school. I've chaired many thesis researches on offshoring and outsourcing. I sit on dissertation committees for people getting a doctorate in business. My students are in their 20s, 30s, and 40s. These aren't kids. You know, they have no clue who was in World War II. And they'll say nobody likes America anymore. So I like to go up to the blackboard and say, well, let's just list the 10 countries that everybody does like. And guess what? They can't name any. And then I like to refer to an English gentleman to give fair balance, who once when asked by the media, why are you so defensive of the United States of America? And he said it so eloquently. Perhaps the best way to take measure of any nation is how many people went in and how many won out. And I think we remember Mr. Tony Blair. I think events of the recent weeks and months has sent a clear and strong message to the world, both our friends and our enemies. You want to be a threat to our well-being and our national security and our way of life, it does not matter how long it takes or how much it costs. We will hunt you down and we will eliminate you. And I say this, my friends, this country will get its house in order, and we'll get our business in order, and we'll assume our rightful leadership role among many nations. I want to talk for a minute about this U.S. Senate race next year. Now, I had a chance to discuss with a few people, you know, before the thing, and for many of us, it's been a while since we had American history. I don't think they even teach it now. You know, the U.S. Senate's a very unique body. They do things no other elected officials do, and you're going to hire someone for that job. I think you would agree with something that important on the line. We need to recognize what the specifics are. What is the job responsibilities I'm hiring someone for so that I can look at their real credentials, not their stump speeches, not their website. their real resume, and does it match? Now, you know, in Florida, we have 40 part-time state senators. We have 120 part-time state house members. They're important people. We have local and county elected officials, and they're important. All of these positions are important, and we need to make sure we put the best credential one for what they're going to do in every position. But when we look at the federal level, we're going to go next year to 27 full-time U.S. congressmen and congresswomen, and we only have 2 full-time federal senators. They have unique responsibilities under the Constitution.